like we had selection of terms in AP, we have selection of terms in GP. So if you have the, you know, if you recall, if three terms were given in AP, we used to consider A minus D, A plus D, like that. Isn't it? These are three terms in AP. Likewise, in GP also, if let's say they are giving three terms in GP. So, three terms in GP. Right? Anyone can guess what could be the three terms in GP? Can you tell me what could be the three terms in GP? So what three, irrespective of the value of A and R, they will always be in GP. So it will be, anyone can think of what will be three terms in GP always? No one, right? Anyone? No clue? So you can take a hint from here. If it was A minus D, A plus D, what will be three terms in GP there? A upon R, A and AR are always in GP. Isn't it? What is the common ratio, guys? Common ratio in this case, R. Common ratio is R. Okay. Tell me, what if you have four terms in GP? Tell me four terms in GP. What will be the four terms in GP? In AP, what used to happen? In AP, if you see, we used to have A minus 3D, A minus D, then A plus D, and then A plus 3D. So here, what do you think should be four terms? Yeah, that's in AP. What about here? Since you see A by R cube, then A upon R, then AR, then AR cube. What is the common ratio? Common ratio in this case? What is the common ratio? R square. Very good. Very good. Third one. Five terms in AP. This will be very simple. Now you could, sorry, five terms in GP. Now you know the pattern. So what will be the five terms in AP, GP? Yes, perfect. So A upon R square, A upon R, AR, AR square. What is the common ratio? Common ratio in this case is R. Very good. Right? So whenever you have to select terms in GP, 3, 4, 5 terms, whatever, you now know. Everyone, let me solve this. Sum of 3 terms in GP, so you know if you have to select 3 terms in GP, what all? A by R plus A plus AR is 38. First equation. And product is 1728, so A by R, and exactly this reason why we took this kind of these terms, right? Because the product may, it helps, 1728. So this R and this R goes, so A cube is 1728, which is 12 cube. So clearly A is equal to 12, right? So A is 12. When A is 12, then you can find out from the first equation, you can write 12 upon R plus 12 plus 12 R is 38. Right? So you can cancel 2. So this is 6, 19. So, and then multiply the entire equation by R. What will you get? 6 plus 6R square is 19. Right? So 6R square, 19R. 19R minus 6R is minus 13R, and then plus 6 is 0. So 6R square minus 9R minus 4R plus 6 is 0. So this becomes 3R common, 2R minus 3, minus 2 common, 2R minus 3 is 0. So 2R minus 3, 3R minus 2 is 0. So you get R is equal to 3 by 2. See again an exercise on quadratic equation. Correct? So two values of R is there and one A was, now what are the terms? A by R, A and AR. So when R is 3 by 2, so this will be 12 by 3 into 2, then 12 and 12 into 3 by 2, which means 8, 12 and 18. So 8, 12 and 18, right? And if R is 2 by 3, then it is 12 into 3 by 2, 12 into 2 by 3. Correct? So 18, 12 and 8. Okay, this is how you